Hello, hello. We're back with Orange. We're in the sacral chakra. Fun, fun, fun. We have lots to say about this chakra. This is your second chakra, the sacral. It is the orange chakra that is located. It's the upper part of the sacrum below the navel. So your solar plexus is behind your navel, but this one here, your sacral chakra, it's in your pelvic region. It's actually a little bit lower than your navel. And the name for this one is Svadhisthana, and the mantra is VAM, V-A-M. Or, you know, of course we would say it as VARM, or VARM with an R, but it's not spelt with an R. Okay, the elemental for the sacral chakra is water. And of course, the element of water is all about emotions. So we have, let's see here, it houses the sexuality, creativity, emotions. It does have a connection to your spirit and soul. It's all about flow. This is where we deal with change and pleasure, creativity, a lot of inspiration in there as well. Okay, so passion, individuality. I was just looking at the crystals. I forgot tiger's eye, but anyhow, that's okay. I brought in some other ones. Okay, so for your body parts that are affected, you know, this one here is really your, it's located by your first lumbar vertebrae, but it affects your, you know, genitourinary, so it's like your urinary system and adrenals and whatnot. So it's all your ovaries and your reproductive organs, all in that area. So there you have that. And I'll just show you the crystals I have here. We have carnelian is what I use mostly for sacral. Carnelian is number one. I just have this skull here. Actually, no. I have a carnelian heart as well. Sometimes it has a little bit of blue running through it. You can place this on your, on the chakra itself. I do have a small Cadbury egg here, carnelian as well. And I use polychrome jasper sometimes when it's overactive. So any crystal with the orange color, orange jasper. We also have tiger's eye is really good for your sacral chakra. Smoky quartz as well. Yes, that's right. I wouldn't have mentioned that. Okay. So some signs that this chakra is having some congestion or could possibly be blocked or, you know, having issues, either overactive, underactive, that kind of thing. We have negativity, like regarding intimacy, loss of creativity. So you have overindulgence as well. Materialistic, can be very moody. Possession, like very possessive over others. Sometimes the issues in this chakra can lead us to being lazy or fatigued. Jealous and envious. Okay. We also have the physical symptoms, having extreme high libido or none at all. So something with the libido being out of balance, feeling unwanted, feeling undesirable or unquenchable. Okay. Addiction lies in the sacral chakra. So when we're doing healing for others with addictive personalities, it may be very helpful to focus on addiction down in the sacral, as well as violence. So signs of violence can indicate that there's some closure in the sacral. All right. So to unblock your sacral chakra, some of the things that you can do, Oh, yes. So sitting in a deep squat position, like a deep squatting position with your feet flat on the floor. And you're going to want to hold it there. You're going to feel some tightness in your thighs and your lower abdomen. But that's just the energy that is residual energy that is kind of being held and it will be released. So doing that squatting position. You may feel tension in legs. Yes, I just mentioned that. The longer you sit in this position, the more of the built-up energy will be released. Sound frequencies that we work with the sacral chakra is 303 hertz, 606 hertz, and 1212 hertz. Areas of massage for reflexology in the foot. It's the middle of the heel pad, so right in the very middle of the heel padding. Foods that we want to eat to help the health of our sacral chakra. Sweet fruits like melons, mangoes, strawberries, passion fruit, oranges, coconut, honey and nuts, cinnamon, vanilla, and sesame seeds. Essential oils, we're looking at, well, a sandalwood as well. So sandalwood's great for crown chakra as well as your sacral. Jasmine, rose, lang lang, and champaka. So those ones are very good for essential oils or incense. And I'm just thinking here. So questions you can ask if you're working with this chakra and just assessing. Do you have love for your sexual partners? Like, do you have love for them? Do you have creativity? Do you enjoy and giving and receiving sexual pleasure in specific? Do you have creative ideas? Are you overly emotional, or are you having a hard time feeling emotion? Anything to do with emotion. So the sacral chakra is very much tied into our heart chakra, okay, and it connects with relationships. And so those two are often connected. If you have a hard time with your sacral chakra, chances are there's something connected to your heart as well that needs some balancing. So what else can I say about it? Yeah, you know, it's one of those things where women will tend to, if we've had any sexual traumas, women or men, but women in specific I want to bring up because there's a crystal that I wanted to recommend for that in specific, but the trauma in sexual relations, like if there's any trauma there from the past, it will be residing within our sacral chakra. So, and it shows up as trauma. And so one crystal that I would recommend, I didn't bring it in, is the rhodonite. So rhodonite is pink and black. And it's amazing for women who've had trauma in this area, okay? Sometimes you will find if you have issues in the sacral chakra, there may be some in the upper heart chakra. So we're not going to go into that one today. But yeah, so it is definitely tied in with the heart. And the sacral chakra, like I love eating like orange peppers and lots of oranges, sweet fruits, you know. But definitely lots of meditation videos on YouTube for the sacral chakra in specific. And color therapy is amazing too. So if you just wear more orange, light therapy, like orange light, that kind of thing, bring some more orange into your life if you're having issues in this area. So that's all we have for the sacral chakra. I'm so excited. Yay! And we're working on our root chakra next. So I have to go do my hair and makeup one more time. My creative juices are definitely flowing because I've done my hair and makeup, but This will be the seventh time today for you guys for these videos. But yeah, it's definitely very creative. So my sacral's doing good. anyways, I love you ladies and guys. Okay, we're going to pop on over to the next video. That's the root chakra, the very last one we're doing for today. Mwah!